We are on the gorgeous northwest coast of Tasmania, in a little place called Devonport, where I grew up. And this is what we know as the Bluff, a beautiful little beach area. And that big building behind us is the restaurant where this man works. That's Mrs. Jones. This is Adam Cole, and he's the chef up there. Now, mate, you're going to show us a dish which has to be the most ordered dish on your menu.
Oh, definitely. It's one of our signature dishes at Mrs. Jones.
Every time I come in, I order this. Someone at the table has to order this because I want to try it. And if they don't, I end up ordering it. So I'm glad you're going to show me how to make it. It is
tempura crab soft shell rolls. So first off, we've floured and battered our crab, and then we've shallow fried it in some vegetable oil.
So soft shell crab is exactly what it sounds like, isn't it?
Yep. They get the crabs when they drop their shell just before they turn into a mature adult.
And that softness means that we can eat the shell and all.
Yep.
So you don't have to take the shell off, you just get it, flour it, fry it, and away we go.
That's it. Lovely crispy.
So we've got these nice, crunchy, crispy crab. What do we do now?
Right, so first we need to get some rice paper sheets.
Yep. And we can buy them at any supermarket.
So we just put them in some water, soften them up.
So they don't need to be too long in the water, just enough to get them wet.
No, just enough, because the excess water on it will slowly absorb into it as we go.
Yep.
And then we'll just slice up some avocado.
Now, avocados, I reckon if you're in the supermarket and you're trying to pick which one is the best one, two little tips. One, always squeeze the top bit here of the avocado, because if you squeeze the middle bit, that's where the stone is, and it gives you a warped sensation. And look for the color on the skin. They start off really green when they're hard, and they'll go through to black at the end when they're really soft. So you want something in the middle, purple green sort of tinge, I reckon. So you're after little slices to go in.
Yep, nice thin slices.
And those slices are really thin. That's a couple of millimeters, I reckon.
So now we'll just place them on. We'll just use half per roll.
I'm the worst rice paper roll roller in the world, I reckon.
Really?
For some reason, I can't do it. My fingers turn into toes when I try and roll rice paper rolls. So I'm gonna watch this intently because I might get better.
Now we'll put some ginger down, some pickled ginger.
So I love how when you pickle ginger, it goes that beautiful pink color.
Yeah, it's a lovely color.
Yeah, a natural sort of dye comes out of it.
And then we'll just fold our edges over, just to hold in the avocado.
I should take notes.
We'll put some herbs in.
Yeah, coriander and Vietnamese mint.
Just so it pokes out the end.
Ah, so I try and make it all tight and nice. It doesn't matter if it pokes out the end?
Nah, not for what we're gonna be using it for.
Okay, very good.
And then we'll right out our crab.
Rightio. And did you just season the flour or the batter?
Yes, yeah. With salt and pepper.
Yep.
Now we're good to roll.
See, I like the way you think. You've done it so that it kind of looks messy. It's meant to look messy. It's a good way of getting out and making sure it looks nice and neat. Ah, look at that. I love that little effect you've got with the avocado.
Yeah.
Always wondered, every time I ate this, how did you do that? Now I know. Wasn't that hard.
No, it's very easy. So now we're ready to plate up.
Rightio.
So we'll just sprinkle a bit of our chili and orange salt on
the top. So that's just normal salt flakes, some chili, some dried chili.
Dried chili, dried orange. And then we just grind it up in the spice grinder.
Yeah. Very nice.
And then we'll slice them. And you can hear that crunch as we go through.
Yum. So how many of these do you reckon the restaurant would do in a week?
On a Friday, Saturday, about 25-30. So they're very popular.
Yeah, very popular. And you can see why. Like, that's just, it's nice and fresh, it's crunchy. The sauce that's about to go on there is gorgeous.
Yep. So this is just our orange lemongrass sauce. First, we start off with some palm sugar, and then we caramelize that, add some ginger, lemongrass, some garlic, a couple of liters of orange juice, reduce that down, and then finish it off with some lime and some fish sauce.
And that's a very versatile dressing as well. Anything, any sort of Asian-inspired cold dish is gonna go really well with that sauce.
Yeah, that's correct.
I'm so happy I learnt how to make that. It wasn't as difficult as I thought it was gonna be. Someone who is terrible at rolling rice paper rolls like me, I reckon I could even do that.
Yeah.
But it doesn't mean I've got any less respect for you, man. I still think it's a great dish, even though it seems a little bit easier than I thought. Can we eat?
We can eat.
Rightio, let's go.